An hour from now, the countdown is on.
Karen Posada live in Pembroke Pines, where you can get some one-on-one help if you still aren't ready for that digital switch. Hi, Karen.
Good morning, South Florida. The digital world is finally here. At 9 o'clock sharp, WSFL and WPLG will be turning off their analog broadcast and turning on their digital switch. And even though this has been in the works for many months, many of you still have some questions. And of course, we've set up a bank. We're teaming up WSFL and WPLG. They've set up a phone bank to answer all your questions. The number for this phone bank is at the bottom of your screen. And again, many people still have some questions out there. Our Chief Director of Engineering at WSFL, good morning, Dan.
Good morning, Karen.
Let's talk about the type of questions that people are asking.
There's a lot of questions today. First, I have to correct something from yesterday. There is a battery-powered DTV down converter, very expensive, $79. So a TV set, a mini 7-inch TV, is actually about $100. So I don't know if it's really worth it if you got batteries. A lot of questions today. Remember, the main thing is they need to auto-program. They got to rescan.
What does that mean exactly for a lot of people who don't understand what that means?
The DTV converter box and the digital ready TVs all have to be rescanned to find the TV channels that are available. For instance, channel 10 at 9 o'clock is actually switching to their new channel, which will also appear as channel 10, but the box won't know it unless you hit auto program.
So you're advising people to do it again tomorrow?
Yes, absolutely. And do it once a week. If TV channels change, if some of us add new channels, they'll want to be able to do that.
So they can basically ask you any questions here, and there's also somebody here from the FCC. So
yes,
the more complicated questions, somebody else is here to answer those for you. And also, people can go to people's houses as well to facilitate them with this change and help them with their converters. Tell me more about that.
They can do that. They can call up and get some help. And some of the help is free help. Senior citizens can get some free help from the Center for Aging. If you call here, we have all the telephone numbers to help everyone out. The other thing that is important to know is that if you have a digital-ready TV, you do not need a converter box. I'm finding a lot of people with converter boxes connected to digital TVs, and all they're doing is converting high def to no def.
You know, people are not doing that for no reason. So can you explain again the type of people that do not have to do anything about it? They just can continue about their lives. What kind of people have to do that?
If you have an LCD TV, there's a pretty good chance it has an ATSC tuner. That's a digital tuner. Of course, if you have cable TV or satellite, you don't have to do anything. They're going to take care of that for you. If you use an antenna, you have to have either a high-definition television set, which will be an LCD TV, and it's going to have to be a couple years old, or within a couple years. Or if you're using an old tube-type TV, you know, a big old screen that's deep, then you're going to have a down converter or a digital converter.
Something else that I've heard from people that have been calling in, a lot of people say, I have signal in some channels and I can't see anything in others. What should they do then?
The position of the antenna makes all the difference in the world. You can adjust the antenna, move it around the room. Before you go out and buy a new antenna, try moving it around the room a little bit. Let it sit, do an auto program again or a channel scan. Remember, when you're using a digital converter, your TV remote control is good for two things: turning the power on and changing the volume. Your converter remote control will be your channel changer from now on, and your menu.
Another question that I have also been hearing, a lot of people have these coupons, but the date is expired. What should they do then?
Call back here, they can reapply. They can reapply if they've been expired. We can clarify it, and Stephanie from the FCC knows all the rules and regs. She can explain that really clearly.
And also, if you need to go out there and buy one, you guys can give them a list of places where they can go buy one as
yes,
well.
Yes, we can give a list of places to buy them, but really any electronics store has them available, along with the 7-inch TVs, the portable TVs, battery-powered, very reasonably priced.
Let's talk about those battery-powered TVs, because we do live in South Florida, and we are worried about natural disasters, right? So what
yes.
should people do then?
The battery-powered TV is really the only way to go now. The little 7-inch LCD TVs run about $100. Real good price is $99. An okay price is about $110. When you get way past that, you're probably paying too much. But you need a battery-powered TV to be able to see the TV stations during a hurricane. And it must have, and I'll say this again, ATSC tuner. That is a digital tuner. The other tuner is called a QAM, Q-A-M. That's digital cable. A little different than high-def TV. It's digital cable TV. So ATSC is what we need for hurricanes.
So if you want to keep your portable TV, but you're choosing to get an adapter and a converter, it's going to cost you probably the same as buying a digital TV at the end.
Yes, it absolutely will. And then you have to deal with batteries dying. So, you know, you have the batteries for the converter, then you have the batteries for the TV, and then the TV is probably going to be black and white. And so your best bet is really to go with just an LCD.
Are some some viewers going to be confused because maybe the channel that they were used to seeing will no longer be that channel?
The number will appear the same. That's the nice thing about digital television. Even if it's really not the same channel, we as consumers on the other end don't know it. It addresses itself the same way it always did. Channel 10 will be 10, 7 will be 7, 6 will be 6. We'll all still be the same. The difference is you'll see us as 39.1 WSFL. 39.2 is Azteca. So TV stations all have the ability to transmit multiple channels on our channel, but they're now the .1, .2, .3 is after our original numbers.
And what's also really interesting about this is that even with an antenna and you're receiving free TV channels, the quality is going to be a lot better.
It is incredible. I mean, I don't want to knock the cable companies. They do a great job, but it is the best picture ever. I mean, it's better than cable because we're not compressing it. We're pushing that high def all the way out there, and it's a beautiful image.
So does that mean they can actually see what we really look like from now on?
Yeah, which could be scary in my case.
No. Well, thank you so much for all your questions. And also, you can find out this information on our website. And again, that number is at the bottom of your screen. If you have any more additional questions, these guys are going to be here till 5 o'clock in the afternoon. And all they want to do is make sure that your transition is as smooth as possible. No question will go unanswered. So please call here if you need any help. We'll send it back to you.
All right. Thanks, Karen. Now, South Florida, you have exactly 22 minutes left to the big switchover. So if you've procrastinated until now and you still need your questions answered, just surf to southflorida.com. We also have information on our website for those of you out there that can't afford these converter boxes on ways you can get it and make it a little bit more affordable because you're running out of time.
Ringing off the hook. Did you see them? They were busy, busy, busy. So take advantage of that, definitely.
All right, time now, 8:37, and time to head upstairs to Sharp Dress John for my favorite part of the